What is good, Horror Horde? This is your boy, Horror Gamer, back with another video for you. And as you can tell by the title of this video, this is another Found Footage Friday. So if you're new to Found Footage Friday, basically, it's what it is. It's Found Footage Friday. I take a found footage movie that I've seen, and I give you my thoughts on it, give you a little review on it, let you guys know if I think it's worth watching or if it's one that you should leave alone. So, but just know, all your boys, Found Footage Fridays have, that's right, spoilers in them all day, every day. So if you haven't seen this particular movie, go check it out, come back, and then let me know in the comment section what you thought about it, whether you enjoyed the movie, whether you hated the movie, whether it's worth the watch, or whether it's something you feel like you should stay away from. So, but just know that anything beyond this point is on you. So, this episode of Found Footage Friday, I decided to go with a movie that was produced by the producer of The Purge and Ouija, and that is Unfriended. So, Unfriended is this story of, basically, it starts out, this girl is caught on video in a park, basically killing herself. And that's it. They don't give you no precedence on why she killed herself or what happened, what made her go to this, until later in the movie. And then you find out that something happened to this person, that a friend that was supposed to be a good friend of hers did something that was terribly wrong and basically embarrassed her to the point where she thought that there was no way to get past it, and so she killed herself. Hence, she comes back during this Zoom call with these friends. I don't know if it's a Zoom call or, like, I don't know what kind of call it is. It's kind of like a Zoom call. And she basically makes each of the friends kill themselves in just horrible ways. Like the one friend, he actually sticks his hand in a damn blender. The other girl, she just annihilates herself. All in all, though, this movie was, it was creepy. It had its creepy points. And then the countdown at the end really, like, set the tone for, like, a very big ending. Like, she would invade their conversation and they would tell her, you know, you need to get out, blah, 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 this, this, and this. And then she would leave and then she would come back. And it was a ghost doing this throughout the whole movie. And, like, truths come out. You know, like, this person slept with this person who's dating this kind of deal. You know what I mean? Like, darkest secrets get unveiled in this movie. And these people, like, basically, she turns this group of friends against each other before she kills them. And then ultimately, it leaves one person left. The one person who was supposed to be her friend, which they do explain in the movie, you know, about midway through, that they kind of, like, broke apart a little bit, and then they got their own, like, series of friends, but they were, like, best friends kind of growing up. And so it concluded with this just epic yet creepy discussion between the main character and the ghost while this countdown is happening. And you know that once this countdown gets to zero, I'm getting chills just thinking about it. Holy shit. Once this countdown gets to zero, something, you know, something's going to happen. Some fuckery ensues. So they're having this conversation, and you know that she's, like, typing out fucking shit, and this girl is, like, answering it, and then the countdown gets to zero. And, like, it's just quietness. Like, there's an eerie stillness at the end of this movie. There's an eerie stillness. And then the girl, the main character, closes the laptop. And when she does, the ghost comes. Like, you see the ghost's face, you know. That big climactic jump scare at the end. Then you know they got fucked. All in all, it was well directed. Like, I love the fact that they went ghost story with it. Like, it did have a sequel, and I will talk about the sequel sometime in the future, where they kind of strayed away from Supernatural and went a different route with the sequel. And it kind of made me not... That'll be another story for another time, but... I love how it was like a... It was a supernatural story, you know? It was a supernatural ghost story that actually kept you at the edge of your seat. Like, you find out that the reason the girl killed herself at the beginning of the movie is because her friends take a video of her drunk at a party, and she ends up shitting herself at this party. And it's like the most embarrassing thing for her. And then, like, they post it. Not only do they take the video, these heartless bitches post the shit on the internet for the world to see, just to embarrass her, and that could fuck somebody up. So this, in my opinion, also had like an undertone of like bullying and how it's not good to bully somebody, you know, because you think it's funny, you're having a good time with this at this person's expense, but you don't know what this person is going through. Like that, like for instance, in this case, that girl had to live with the fact that her friends posted a video of her dead drunk lying on the ground in a pile of her own feces. And these people thought it was a good idea to put that on the internet. And it drove this girl to kill herself. And that's what it is. You know, there was a hidden message, in my opinion, in this movie that, you know, bullying is fucking stupid. Like, you don't know what you can do. You don't know the harm you could do to somebody with bullying, you know, to the point where they kill themselves, you know what I'm saying? And you think, you know, you bully somebody because you want to look cool in front of friends, or because you have issues and you know, you got to put that on somebody else, but you don't understand the fucking damage you do to somebody when you bully somebody. And this kind of exploits that in a good way. It brings it to light. So I definitely recommend that you give this movie a check. Like, if you haven't seen it, check it out. It's a definite good watch. It's definitely a good watch. It's a good creepy movie. It's one of those turn off all the lights, get yourself a bucket of popcorn and a cold drink, and you just watch this movie and you just watch it for what it is. You know, it's a fantastic movie. It's a fun ride. It's really well made. Definitely recommend you check it out. Unfriended Horror Horde is 100%. Horror Gamer approved. And I really hope you enjoyed this week's Found Footage Friday. Like I said, go check it out. Fun time, guys. Definitely fun time. All right, Horror Horde. With all that being said, like I said, I really hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it for you today. And if you haven't done so yet, hit that subscribe button along with that dingly ding ding button. That way, every time your boy Horror Gamer throws up one of these Found Footage Fridays, you're in the know. And then when you're done doing that, head on over to the Horror Gamer Patreon and see what kind of cool stuff we got going on. Like I said, we have our movie nights and our hangout nights where we get together and just watch movies and just chill and relax and have a good time. You know, now with new movies coming straight to digital streaming services, we're watching newer movies, which is fun. Movies that should be in theaters. So it's like a digital movie. It's like going to the movie theater digitally now. So, and then when you're done doing that, I will be leaving the link in the description below, by the way. But then when you're done doing that, head on over to the Z Network and see what kind of cool stuff we got going on out there. Bunch of us creators got together and just created a little something for everybody. So, all right, Horror Horde, with all that being said, I love you guys. Thank you guys. And until next time, this is your boy Horror Gamer saying, as always, don't fear the darkness. Embrace it.